So here we'll talk a little bit about weed ID. So a couple of different characteristics we want to pay attention to when approaching a weed. Here we are dealing with giant ragweed, but certainly a couple things to pay attention to. Number one would be hairs on the plant. So here we're looking at either stem hairs, leaves on, or hairs on those petioles, hairs on those leaf surfaces is going to be one of the characteristics we're going to use to identify these different weeds. Of course, giant ragweed here does have hairs. Other characteristics we're going to look for is leaf orientation. So here we have opposite leaf orientation. Some plants will have an alternate pattern, is going to be another trait that we can look for to help identify different weeds that we're not familiar with. Another could be leaf shape. So here we're having giant ragweed, which is very deeply lobed with these larger lobes. Other plants, of course, will have different edges, you know, either a serrated edge, smooth edges. Different leaf characteristics are some of those traits we're going to be looking for. And then certainly flowering structure, especially when we talk about some of the pigweed species. They can be very challenging to identify between one another during the vegetative stages. But if we look at those flowering structures, they can be another good tip, whether it's flower color, shape, and orientation with some of those characteristics. Here with giant ragweed, we're looking at a giant ragweed plant here, you know, looking at those deep lobes. We do have another kind of close relative to giant ragweed here as well. This is a common ragweed plant, which is kind of really the younger brother version of giant ragweed. You can see the leaf orientation is slightly different there. Still have an opposite leaf orientation. However, those lobes on those leaves are much more pronounced on that common ragweed plant. Otherwise, flowering structure and other traits are very similar between that common and giant ragweed plant. So here we have a couple of different pigweeds we're looking at. Here I've got actually a Powell Amaranth. So Powell Amaranth. And this is actually a monoecious weed compared to plants like Waterhemp or Palmer that are dioecious. So what that means is there's actually male and female flower parts on the same plant. So here if we look at the seed head, certainly is a great characteristic to do some weed ID. Late August, you know, it's a good time to, you know, identify which weeds you have and where they might be, do a little bit of weed mapping. So here the Powell Amaranth plant actually does have some hairs on that plant. However, this plant is a good example of where those hairs are very difficult to see. You know, on the camera, it might be difficult to see, but if you hold it up to the light, you can typically see those hairs just a little bit better. Or even if you dump a little bit of water on that plant, those hairs tend to stand up just a little bit. But Powell Amaranth tends to be a pigweed that doesn't have a lot of hairs, especially this time of year. They can be fairly difficult to see. The leaf shape tends to be a little bit more broad in leaf shape compared to Waterhemp, which will have a little bit longer and more lanceolate leaf shape. Similar to this Waterhemp leaf here, obviously it is a little bit more of a lancelet leaf shape, longer and skinnier in that regard. So Powell Amaranth, one of the identifying characteristics, like I mentioned, was leaf hairs. Red root pigweed will have even more hairs than this. It typically will be very easy to see those hairs on the stems and leaves of a red root pigweed plant. Powell Amaranth just has a few hairs. If we talk about no hairs on a pigweed, we either have two choices. It's either Waterhemp or Palmer Amaranth. And in this case, we have a Waterhemp plant based on a few different factors. Number one would be petiole length, as well as leaf shape, or some of those clues that we have to identify Waterhemp versus Palmer Amaranth.